lost the meeting host?
Oh, we are recording now.
Yeah, I am. I did start the recording now somehow.
Okay. Yeah, you are meeting host.
Perfect.
You just got promoted to moderator.
Anyway, welcome everyone to the IPLD weekly meeting that happens for the first time ever on Friday, because last time Nicola didn't send invite to anyone and it was Nicola by himself. And I'm very sorry for everyone because we basically lost 1 week of updates. Actually, maybe 2 weeks of updates, because the previous week was Monday and then it happened on Friday. Mm-hmm. And I promise you, I confirmed the day and not even myself got an update. I just remember that it was midday.
No worries. It's good.
Anyway, yeah. So I hope we'll have a lot of stuff to discuss. The very first thing I would like to do is to go over the agenda, the previous review that ticket, because I was a day after the call I made this roadmap and I asked for feedback, but I know that you have your own calendar and I don't know about your own calendar, so there are a few things like release the IPLD libraries or add IPLD CLI support or create the IPLD namespace. These are all things that I have notes from the team week, and I don't know when they position in the calendar. The only thing that I know is that if they don't have a place in the calendar, they should happen before this quarter.
The update there is that IPLD was merged in just IPFS and GoIPFS. The DAG API is being discussed right now. Like GoIPFS has a DAG API, but just some problems in terms of implementation details. And okay. Like the implementation can bubble up some things that need to be exposed as explicit options on the interface itself. Yep. I've been requesting one to review that and to give his intake. I propose a solution. I can point you to the right issue to look at it. And I can really appreciate your feedback as a consumer of this API. Nevertheless, there is already support for both MerkleDAG, CWAR, Ethereum blocks, Zcash, and Git across JS and Go in terms of IPLD formats. There is also, again, just to avoid confusions, there is the interface IPLD format, which is the block scope, resolve, and links function that we talked in the last gathering. The thing that enables the IPLD main resolver to go through different formats. And then there is the DAG API, which is parallel to the object API was for protobufs, but that gets exposed at the top level IPFS, CLI, and like the programmatic interface. So again, just emphasize different APIs. Wait to go.
Okay, so the reason why I am raising this is because I would like to put them possibly on a timeline, and there are a few things that I've been following on GitHub, like I've been seeing the CLI work, but it would be if you have links, drop them in this issue, because other people might have time to follow what's going on, unless they live in 10 different repositories. Well, in here, they can just come and see what's happening.
Sounds good to me.
Okay.
Posting the wishes and taking all the notes from what I just said.
Perfect. And okay, so about the timeline, is there something else that the overall outcomes of this quarter, is something else that I've been missing out? I think that this is all. Shipping usable IPLD support, the IPLD website, the IPLD paper, and the spec. And the IPLD support is the bigger chunk, and it's about making usable libraries, the CLI support, and IPLD on IPFS, which also means namespace, and the ability to resolve IPLD objects.
True. The thing is, like, those things are essentially blocked till there is some thoughtful review of implementations, plus interfaces. Right now, me and Jeremy are walking in the dark because no one that has been seriously involved with IPLD has been giving feedback. And that's like totally understandable. We know people have been busy, so okay. What I'm saying is, even before talking about like namespace on the gateway, like there is no going to be a release of IPLD till there is like people trying and building things with it and saying, hey, like this doesn't make sense.
It should okay, be- so this is a major blocking issue for you.
Yeah. Again, the tag API is a major blocking issue, yes.
Okay. Do you have some links you want to drop?
I have dropped already on the iPad. Can you see that?
Oh, at the very end. The last one.
33 and 34. So interface IPLD format, I'm happy with it till the extent of it enables the IPLD resolver to work. And like other people are already implementing formats. That's why we have both the XIPboard and IPV, and also Ethereum and Git and Zcash. That's okay. That's fine. Let's need to review. You can review it if you want. But what I'm saying is not broken. The thing that like is annoying to implement is the DAG API. And the reason why it's annoying, it's all described, it's a big issue. I have my proposal that I think is a solution, but it escapes a little bit of like it is normal in these things. It might sound off, but when you see all the constraints, it's like, okay, fine, that's like what we have to do. But again, I want people's feedback and like tinkering with it.
What do you leave the links? Do you put it in this document?
Yeah, are you not seeing them?
Is it at the very end?
So there is like 37 lines in this segment. Well, the links are on line 33 and 34.
Okay. So there are two issues. Well, they link to other issues, but this is the two links. Okay.
So there is, let me get back to your roadmap. So.
Okay.
And like, again, I definitely strongly think that like we need to get people using IPLD because right now it's just like something that's like inside the guts of IPFS. Having IPLD playground would be the best playground. I know that like the IPLD playground right now is like on second priority compared to just like having the IPLD website.
Yeah, but remember that these two priorities like are close to each, at least conceptually are close to each other. One is going to be in a few weeks, and one is going to be in a few weeks after. But yeah, we are on the same page.
We'll definitely help setting these interfaces.
Okay, so we can.
This is like the last chance that we get, like to stamp, like a completely green field of the interface. Once we achieve one thing, people start using it, and then like if we don't think this thing through, it's going to get painful to migrate and upgrade these APIs as it has asked for some cases. So we really need people looking at it.
Okay, so I think we should make a stronger call to review for this, me included. It's very important that we get that. Okay, so the review of the roadmap, I think is, unless there is something else to add, we can move forward. Now, the website, we had an intense conversation with Victor and Richard. About the website, there is this milestone that shows Victor does an amazing job at writing, opening an issue for each of the things that we discussed. And Victor, we all have been sick in the past week. And I think on the website side, there are still things that might be slightly delayed. But me, Victor, and Richard have discussed the website fully, and me and Richard are now going to write the there is an issue which I'm going to link you in a second, which is about the second page for IPLD. The first page is about see what's going on, and the second page is learn about IPLD, and we're going through this learn how to use IPLD narrative. And of course, David, chip in, because we want to explain IPLD from zero to how I can use it today on the website. Yeah, it should be a very introductory. Then, if you want, you can read the spec. But we don't want the spec to be the first place where you go to learn about IPLD.
Sounds good.
There are some, no, I think this is like less important. we can just discuss
that. On the spec that you just mentioned, one of the items I brought to the last chat about IPLD was CID, and the fact that like right now it's still like a thing that gets referenced by an issue that says experimental, which is like not very concerning for people that like want to come into the CID world and IPLD world, and that we need like a repo or the document that says this is a spec for CID, and this is like the same way that we have all the other specs, right?
Okay, so about CID, there is a deadline for the IPLD draft of the spec, but is what you're saying that you want something before that?
I think CID and IPLD do not need to be the same spec. I think CID consumes the CID spec,
yeah.
And the CID spec just needs to be what is an issue written in a way that people can implement in their own language. The same way that we have multi-codec, multi-other, and all so on. And we have already two implementations, so like it's even easier for people to understand what it is. But like having an issue that says experimental in caps lock is just not helpful for a lot of people that enter in that world.
Okay. So what are you proposing in practice? That we write something?
Just on a document, like a README, like that grabs everything that has been thrown at that issue and converts it in a nice reading.
Yeah.
Just that. So, CID spec.
CID spec is a bigger effort than what you just described. What you just described is just explain CID in short.
Explain CID in short and like the hints to tell people how to implement it. It is like, since like CID consumes multi-hash and consumes multi-codec.
There's very little to.
It is just like a concatenation of the tree and like a justification why this makes sense for IPLD, which doesn't ever have to be on the CID spec. Like, then IPLD can justify CIDs make sense because A, B, and C, right? So,
okay, so you want to put this on the timeline like much early, like this week?
Yeah, like, I think it will be, like, I think it is really important right now.
Let's just do it this week. Well, next week. Okay. Perfect. I just added to the timeline, but it's good to have notes in here. Okay. Okay, so the website effort going on. Hold on, we talked about that. Paper update. We finally decided where we're gonna submit, what type of paper is gonna be. And it's gonna be a short paper for the World Wide Web conference. And there are thousands of other places where we could have done, and there's thousands of lengths of the paper that we could have put, but we just want to explain in short, in a simple way, IPLD. And at the very beginning, we didn't care about conferences, but if we have to pick a conference that fits this type of design that we're going to give to the paper anyway, then that's the place where we would like to submit. Now, I would like to ping you, David, maybe offline. For some questions or understand how you can be involved in this.
Sounds good. Let me know when you have time. I can do it early next week.
Otherwise, I don't know if you've seen the other conversations, but I hold office hours every Friday and Wednesday.
Okay, I can do Wednesday. Friday, I will be in Berlin for a hackathon.
What I mean by today.
Okay, we can chat today. There is also the research hall.
Yeah, exactly. That's also a perfect venue.
Okay, so when is the conference? Do we have a date on that one and a URL?
Sorry?
Where is the World Wide Web conference? Yeah. When it is, like on time, which one, which day?
Is that all of this information are going to be on our own repo. The deadlines for the demo paper, for the short papers, is not been announced, but I know that it's going to be in January.
Okay, January.
Okie dokie.
All right.
Okay. Oh yeah, perfect. You're writing that down. Okay. Then you wanted to mention about the state of things of implementation feedbacks, but I think we discussed that, right?
Yeah, correct.
Okay. So is there any other point before I talk about this off topic? Is there something that is that happened the past 2 weeks that, or that we haven't given priority outside of the things that we mentioned?
I don't think there isn't. It's really right now the development happened, the merging happened, the new feedback. I think that's the big pressing issue right now. A lot of people are getting excited, they're getting feedback, we're getting other people to build IPLD formats. We are getting people that considered rewriting their entire data model to like support IPFS data structures, and then like they realize, oh, I don't need to do that anymore. That's exciting. Can I use it now? So yeah, we need right now. Like we have a lot of momentum and interest, but no one is really like taking advantage of the work that has been put in this quarter because there has been no review, like official announcement saying, hey, people, try this now. So this is like one of the priorities of Q3, even we should definitely put more energy there. That's all I have to say. But yeah, everything sounds good.
Okay. Okay. There's something I'm just mentioning just because it has been part of the conversations in which is. The way we do IPLD today is that we have data is in one node and each node links to another node which has also data, which basically means if I want to say they have this Merkle DAG and I want to prove that something is a that there is a at the very leaf of this Merkle DAG, at the very end of this Merkle DAG, I will have to in order to prove that this thing belongs to the graph which has this particular hash, I will have to give all the path of nodes till the hash. But the issue is that if these nodes in the middle contain data, then the proof it's as big as like one branch of the data. And in leaf-based IPLD is basically a transformation. What you have is you build IPLD such that data is only contained at the leaf, and in the middle, from the root to the leaves, there is the only thing that is there is the a sort of nodes only contain the smallest amount of information for you to resolve a path. So basically, proving that one piece of data belongs to IPLD is not as big as the data of the nodes in between, but it's also as big as the path. It's only as big as the path. So basically, you want to offer a secure, say that you have bigger objects than smaller objects. Yeah, yes, you can share them, you can do all of these things, but there is this trade-off between the size of the nodes in between and the amount of, basically for some type of problems, which are some problems I'm working on right now, having nodes in the leaf and having intermediate nodes which contain data is literally inefficient. And this I'm working on this on spare time, but it's basically a very useful transformation that you can build on top of current IPLD. So basically, you have an IPLD graph, but whenever you have a path, the path that doesn't resolve to an intermediate node, but it's always forced to resolve on a leaf. so that whenever you want to prove that some data belongs to a dataset, it's very cheap. I just wanted to mention this as an off topic. This is not part of the IPLD effort.
Yeah, I'm not 100% sure if I follow everything. It sounds...
I did a huge write-up.
Yeah, like definitely having some examples will help. Right now what I'm hearing you saying is, hey, like we'll have these like files that will not fit in OneNote. So we have to create several nodes with them. But we want to make sure that these nodes, like that each of those nodes that we have to create with parts of the file belongs to this bigger file. So I'm going to have a path to this other node that like eventually through some chain of links will point to all these chunks of the file. And we want to say that this node is not only a node, but actually it's a collection. It should be extracted from IPLD as a collection that like concatenates all the other nodes so that the file is recreated again as I added.
The concatenation is not what I'm worrying about.
What I mean is like if you look at UnixFS, like a file, when you add a file to UnixFS, like the when you say like an hash for a file, you are pointing to a node that only says, hey, like this node is a type file. And then like you fetch all the links and those links are raw leaves. And raw leaves are just like binary blobs that are composed of.
Yes, exactly. In UnixFS, this UnixFS is almost a leaf-based transformation. Your folders are very small. But say that I build a social network where my node is contains some other, the node by myself contains other information, and the node by yourself contains other information, then you might end up building a very inefficient graph whenever you want to prove that something is in the graph. With this transformation, you force everything to be at the leaf. And in the same way, UnixFS forces everything, all the data blob to be at the leaf.
I see.
Yeah, I just want to make sure that people are going to write IPLD in the same way, but I want to make, so an IPLD object is described in the same way, it's just that the hash function is different. But I want to make sure that people don't build super inefficient graphs and the rest of humanity, whenever they want to prove something, they will have to download the entire
universe. Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. And I guess one of the good things with IPLD is that I get a very good playground to build all of these structs.
Exactly. This is what this is an example of what people could build with IPLD.
I'm sure there will be even competitions of people building data structures on top of IPFS. The most efficient one to search.
Yeah, maybe we should launch a challenge.
Yeah, maybe just build things and show us where it breaks.
Yeah, I think that's a very good idea. Anyway, unless someone has anything to add, I see some messages in the chat, which is Nick Peek from the website. So we were discussing.
I was looking at IRC and then Slack and then opening several channels in Slack and finally I realized we're talking about the chat in Zoom. All right, Git tree structure, sweet.
Basically, the problem was that in the previous IPLD website, you had examples that were taking an entire line, and then we discussed that it's more educational if you have on one side some example and on the other side the explanation of that example.
Sounds good.
Anyway, I think we are done in 30 minutes. Woohoo!
So efficient.
Anyway.
Your Latin is perfect. I see through the sneak peek that you're very fluent.
Sorry, again?
I like the explanation, right? Against the Lorem Ipsum.
Yeah, me and Victor have IPLD chat in Latin because I think Latin is the universal language.
It is, of course. All right. Cool. So we have a research call in 30 minutes. Sounds good. To be honest, I will not have anything to speak about because I was at that summit for my weekly research time, so I didn't do any reading this week.
Okay, wait. Let's just close this chat. This conversation over here for IPLD, and then we move to the next. At least let's stop the recording now.
Okay. That's it, Victor.
Bye, everyone.